Good morning, students. Today I am going to explain the last part of lesson number 3, Cultural Heritage of India's Culture and Architecture. The points to be discussed today are medieval architecture, architecture of Gujarat, and linear sketch of a mosque. Medieval architecture. Write down this question in your textbook. Write about the architecture in the medieval period. Medieval period means the period between the ancient period and the modern period is known as a medieval period. It was from 5th century to 15th century. So during that period, India was ruled by the sultans, that Muslim kings. They are known as a sultanate. So medieval India was the period of the rule of a Delhi Sultanate. During that time, they built many mosques, minarets, royal palaces, bridges and inns. So medieval period was the period of that is Delhi Sultanate. And what did they build? They built mosques, minarets, royal palaces, bridges and inns. Qutbuddin Aibak, he was the founder of Slay dynasty in India. And he constructed Qutub Minar. He also built a Quwwatul Islam Mosque in Delhi and Adai Din Ka Chopra Mosque in Ajmer. Adai Din Ka Chopra, that mosque was built within 2.5 days. That is why it is called Adai Din Ka Chopra. Where it is built? It is built in Ajmer. So medieval India was the period of the rule of Delhi Sultanate. These Delhi Sultans, they built mosques, minarets, royal palaces, bridges and inns in India. Who was the founder of slave dynasty? Qutbuddin Aibak. What did he construct? He constructed Qutub Minar, then Qutbuddin Islam Mosque in Delhi, and Adai Din Ka Chopra Mosque in Ajmer. Then in Bengal, Adina Mosque at Pandua, then tomb of Jalaluddin Muhammad Shah, and Tantipura Mosque. They are the specimens of medieval architecture. So which are the specimens of medieval architecture of Bengal? Adina Mosque at Pandua, tomb of Jalaluddin Muhammad Shah and Tantipura Mosque. So write about the architecture in the medieval period. Medieval India was the period of a rule of Delhi Sultanate. The architecture of a mosque, minarets, royal palaces and bridges are seen in the medieval age. Qutbuddin Aibak, who was he? Was the founder of slave dynasty. He constructed Qutub Minar, Qutbuddin Islam Mosque in Delhi and Adai Din Ka Chopra Mosque in Ajmer. In Bengal, Adina Mosque at Pandua, tomb of Jalaluddin Muhammad Shah and Tantipura Mosque are the specimens of a medieval architecture. In Jaunpur, in Uttar Pradesh, Atala Mosque was built by the rulers of Turkey. What is the speciality of that Atala Mosque? There is an artistic skill around the dome and the ceiling is decorated with Indian designs, including lotus. So in medieval period, in Jaunpur, which mosque was built? Atala Mosque. Who built that? It was built by the rulers of Turkey. What is the speciality of that mosque? There is an artistic grill around the dome and the ceiling is decorated with Indian designs including lotus. Then in Malwa, in Madhya Pradesh, in Malwa, which structures are remarkable? Mandu buildings, tombs with the impressive domes and carvings, and marble tomb of Hoshangsha. They are remarkable. Then other places, other provinces. In other regions, Bamini rulers, they built a Gol Gumbaj at Bijapur in Karnataka, madrasas that are imparting religious knowledge to the Muslim children. School for imparting religious knowledge to the Muslim children. That is called a madrasas. Madrasas are built at Bidar and Gulbarga. So Bamini rulers built which construction, which structures? Gol Gumbaj at Bijapur, madrasas at Bidar and Gulbarga. The rulers of Vijayanagar built Vithala Swami and Hazar Rama temples and many gopurams. So who built the temples of Vithala Swami and Hazar Rama, that rulers of Vijayanagar? So that question is that write about the architecture in the medieval India. What you will write? Medieval period was the rule of Delhi Sultanate. Qutbuddin Aibak, the founder of slave dynasty, built Qutub Minar, then Quwwatul Islam Mosque, and Adaiddin Ka Chopra in Ajmer, then in Bengal. Adina Mosque at Pandua. Tomb of Jalaluddin Muhammad Shah and Tandipura Mosque are the specimens of a medieval architecture. Jaunpur. In Jaunpur, Adala Mosque was built by the rulers of Delhi of Turkey. What is the speciality of that Adala Mosque? There is an artistic grill around the dome and the ceiling is decorated with Indian designs including lotus. Then in Malwa, which structures are remarkable in Malwa? Mandu buildings, tombs with impressive domes and carvings and marble tomb of Hoshang Shah. Then what was constructed by the Bamini rulers? Gol Gumbaj at Bijapur, Madrasa at Bidar and Gulbarga. Then who built the temples of Vithala Swami and Hazar Rama? That are the rulers of Vijayanagar. The next topic is architecture of Gujarat. So write about the progress of architecture in Gujarat. Write down this question in your textbook. Sculpture and architecture of Gujarat include temples of various religions, mosque, viharas of Buddhist religion, mutts, stupas, chaityas, cave temples, Jain temples. So during the medieval period in Gujarat, many temples of different religions. Mosque, worshipping place of the Muslims. Viharas of Buddhist religion, resting place of that resting place in a stupa in Buddhist religion is called a viharas. Mutts, living place of that saints. Then stupas, Buddhist temples are called stupas. It is oval in shape under which the remains of Lord Buddha's body like teeth, nails, hair, bones, ashes were kept in a box. Chaityas, big hole in a stupa is called a chaityas. Cave temples, then Jain temples were built in the medieval period. Besides this, different types of building also that is useful to the society were built. Royal palaces, then forts, domes, gates, Kirti Stambha. Here I showed, this is that Kirti Stambha. Then that inns, then Upasraya, this is Upasraya. Then Visamas, then that veranda, skylight, this is Jaruku, this is that Jaruku. Then watchtower, arcs, wells, step wells, lakes, ponds, and figures of animals and birds. They are the beautiful and magnificent structures. So during the medieval period, structure, culture and architecture of Gujarat were made. They include temples of various religions, mosque, viharas of Buddhist religion, mutts, stupas, chaityas, cave temples, and Jain temples. Besides that, different types of buildings that is useful for the society also were built, like royal palaces, that a place where that kings used to live, forts, killas, domes, that on the top of that Muslim mosque, we can find this mosque. Then gates, Kirti Stambha, this is that Kirti Stambha, that tower of fame. Then inns, Upasraya, this is that. Then Vistamas, then veranda, skylight. Then Jaruko, this is that. Then watchtower, arcs, bells, step bells, lakes and ponds, figures of animals and birds. They are the most beautiful and magnificent structures. Then during that period, many temples of different sects were built. Different sections of Hindu religion were built in Gujarat. They are the temples of Bhadrakali, then Gita Mandir, then Veda temple, Jagannath temple, it is at Dakur, Sun temple of Modera, Hatkeshwar Mahadev temple at Vatnagar, Ambaji temple, Shyamalaji temple, Somnath temple at Dwarka, then Bahujarji temple, Mahakali temple at Pavagadh, Swami Narayan temples, Brahmaji temple, where it is located at Ked Brahma, Kodiyar Madaji temple, Bhavnagar, then Mutt of Ashapurama, So, which are the temples built during the medieval period? Temples of different sections of Hindu religion have been built in Gujarat. They are the temple of Bhadrakali. This is that Bhadrakali temple. Then Gita Mandir, Veda temple, Jagannath temple at Thakur. This is that. Then some temple of Modera, Hatkeshwar Mahadev temple at Vatnagar. Then Ambaji temple, Shyamlaji temple. Then that the Somnath temple. This is that Somnath temple at Dwarka. Bhojarji temple, Mahakali temple at Pavagadh. Then Swami Narayan temples, Brahmaji temple, where it is located at Khed Brahma. Mataji temple, that is at Bhavnagar. Mattu of Ashapurama, where it is in Kutch. All these are where it is located, that also you have to study for objectives. As the following or that MCQs they will ask. Where is Jagannath temple situated at Dakor? Sun temple of Gujarat, where it is situated, Modera. Sun temple of Konark, where it is situated, Odisha. Then Hatkeshwar Mahadev temple, where it is located, Vatnagar. Then Somnath temple, where it is situated, Dwarka. Then Mahakali temple, where it is located, Pavagadh. Then Brahmaji temple, where it is located, Ked Brahma. Kodiyar Madaji temple, where it is located at Bhavnagar. Then Mattu of Ashapurama, where it is located at Kutch. Then mosque. We have seen in the medieval period was the period of that Muslim kings. So they built many mosques in Gujarat. That Jama Masjid, it is situated at Teen Darwaja in Ahmedabad. And it was built by Ahmad Shah first in 1423. And it how many pillars and how many domes it has? 260 pillars and 15 domes. So who built Jama Masjid, where it is located, Ahmad Shah first. When it was built, 1423. Where it is located, Teen Darwaja in Ahmedabad. How many pillars and how many domes it has? 260 pillars and 15 domes it has. And the other structures are Siddhi Sayyid Grill. This is that Teen Darwaja. This is that Siddhi Sayyid Grill. You can see that very, very minute carvings are there. Small, small carvings are there. Then Roja Circus. Then shaking towers. Ahmedabad. If we will shake one tower, other towers also will automatically shake. And it is in Ahmedabad. Many people try to find out the reason, but it still remains a history. Then Mosque of Queen Sipri. It is also known as a Mosque of Nagina. And Jama Masjid at Champaner. This is that Jama Masjid at Champaner. And many other such mosques were built in big cities of Gujarat. And the next one is Jain temples. We have seen that Jain religion spread in Gujarat. And with the spread of Jain religion, many temples were built in Gujarat. They are Jain temples of Arti Singh, Kumbhariaji, Sangeshwar, then Siddhagiri, Shatranjaygiri, Palitana. They are famous from sculpture, architecture and carving points of view. Then fourth one is step wells of Gujarat. So which are step wells of Gujarat are that step wells means wells, kuva saying, and in order to take water from the wells, steps are there. So which step wells of Gujarat are famous? Step well of Adalaj, then step well of Dada Hari. It is known as Harini Vav. It is located in Ahmedabad. Then Ranini step well of Patan. This is that Ranini step well of Patan. Then Hira Bagor of that Daboy. They are the splendid examples of a step well construction. So which Jain temples are famous? Jain temples of Arti Singh. This is that Jain temples of Arti Singh. Kumbhariaji, Sangeshwar, then Siddhagiri, Shatranjaygiri, Palitana. They are famous from sculpture, architecture and a carving point of view. Then which step wells are famous in Gujarat? Step wells of Adalaj, then step well of Dada Hari, that is known as a Hariniva, where it is located in Ahmedabad. Then Ranini step well of Patan. This is that Ranini step well. Then Hira Bagor of Daboy. They are the splendid examples of a step well construction. Then other specimens of architecture are, other examples of architecture are Fort of Badra. Then Teen Darwaja. Then that Nagina Wadi, Kangaria Lake, where it is located in Ahmedabad. Then Rudra Mahalaya, where it is located in Siddhapur. Then Sahasraling Lake in Patan. Then Chori of Shamalji. Then next, Samadhi of Tanariri. Then Kirti Toran at Vadnagar. They are the famous temples. So write a note, write about the progress of architecture in Gujarat. Temples of different religions, mosque, vihara, stupas, cave temples and chaityas of Buddhist religion and Jain religions indicate a remarkable progress of architecture in Gujarat. Besides that, royal palaces, forts, domes, gates, kirti stams, dharmashalas, upasrayas, wells, step wells, lakes and ponds, figures of animals and birds are the other beautiful specimens. Then temples of a different sect of a Hindu religion built in large numbers in Gujarat, which are the famous temples, Bhadrakali temple, Gita Mandir, Veda temple, Jagannath temple in Ahmedabad, Tanjotrai temple in Thapur, then Sun temple in Modera, Hatkeshwar Mahadev temple in Vatnagar, Ambaji temple, then Shamlaji temple, Somnath temple, Jagat temples in Dwarka, Bahujarji temple, Mahakali temple in Pavagadh, then Swami Narayan temple, Brahmaji temple in Kedar Brahma, Kodiyar Mataji temple in Bhavnagar, Ashapurama temple in Kutch, then mosque. Mosques were also built by the Muslim rulers, which are the famous mosques. Jama Masjid, who built in Ahmedabad, that is Sultan Ahmad Shah first. When it was built in 1423. And what is the how many pillars and how many domes it has? 260 pillars and that 15 domes are there. Then other that are Muslim architecture are Siddi Sayyid Grill, Mosque of Queen Cyprian Ahmedabad, Roja Circuit and Jama Masjid of that are Chambali. Then Jain temples. Many Jain temples were built in Gujarat. Jain temples of Hathi Singh, Kumbhariaji, Changeshwar, Siddhagiri, Shatranjaygiri, Palitana. They are quite well known from sculpture, architecture and a carving point of view. Then step well of Gujarat. Step wells were built at Adalaj, then step well of Dada Hari. It is known as a Harini Vav in Ahmedabad. Ranini, step well of Patan, Hira Bagol of Daboi. They are the splendid examples of a step well construction. Then other specimens of architecture are Fort of Badra, Teen Darwaja, Nagina Wadi, Kankaria Lake in Ahmedabad, Rudra Mahalaya in Siddhapur, Sasraling Lake in Patan, Chori of Shamlaji, then Samadhi of Tanariri, Kirti Toran at Vatnagar, etc. Now, linear sketch of a mosque. Linear sketch means a parts of that mosque. First one is a Galiara. Galiara means the way to enter and exit from the mosque. So, in objectives, they will ask, what is Galiara? That are the way to enter and exit from the mosque. So what is the way to enter and exit from the mosque known as a Galiara? Then Qibla. It is a part of a mosque or a hall where namaz is performed. So what is Qibla? Part of a mosque or hall where that namaz is performed. What is namaz? The Muslim prayer is called a namaz. And it is always in the direction of a Kaaba. Kaaba means it is the that sacred place of that Muslims. Then Mahrab, that inner part of that interior part of the mosque wall. And its height is of a human beings. And it indicates that correct direction to Mecca. Mecca is the place where that Prophet Muhammad, the founder of Islam religion, was born. And in India, it is always in the western direction. So what is Mahrab? The inner part of the mosque wall, which is of a human height. It is in the direction to Mecca. And in India, it is always in the western direction. Then Sahan, campus of a mosque where the followers of Islam get together for prayer is known as Sahan. Means before performing the prayers, that followers of Islam, they gather. That canvas is called a Sahan. So what is Galiara? The way to enter and exit from the mosque is called a Galiara. Then what is a Qibla? The part of the mosque or hall where that namaz is performed. And it is always in the direction of a Kaaba. Then what is that Mahrab? The interior part of the mosque wall, which is of a human height. And it indicates the correct direction to Mecca, is known as a Mahrab. And in India, that Mahrab is always in the western direction. Then Sahan. What is the meaning of a Sahan? The canvas of a mosque where the followers of Islam get together for prayer is known as a Sahan. Then Livan. Livan is a Livan. Room in a mosque with the pillars is called a Livan. Then Maksura. Maksura is a, this is that end of the mosque, and which is that is separated by a railing. Here you can see that railing. So what is a Livan? The room in a mosque with the pillars is called a Livan. Then what is that a Maksura? End of a mosque wall which is separated by a, which is separated by a railing is called a Maksura. Then, so which are the linear sketch of a, that a mosque? What is a Galiyara? This is that a Galiyara. The way to enter and exit in a mosque is called a Galiyara. The next one is the Qibla. This is that a Qibla. That a part of a mosque. Hall where that a Muslim that a perform their namaz. And it is always in the direction of a Kaaba, sacred place of a, that a Muslim. Part of a mosque or a hall where that a Muslims offer their namaz. It is always in the direction of a Kaaba. The next one is a Mahrab. Mahrab, this is that a Mahrab. That a interior part of the mosque wall. And it's a height is of a human beings. And it is in the direction to Mecca. And in that India always it is in the western direction. That is this a Mahrab it is. Then next one is a Sahan. This is that a Sahan. The canvas where that Muslims before performing the namaz get together. That canvas is called a Sahan it is. Then Livan. The room in a mosque with the pillars is called a Livan. Then Maksura. This is that end of the mosque wall which is known as a Maksura. It is separated by a railing. So that today we have a, let us revise what we have a studied today. First one is that architecture of a, that write about the architecture in medieval India. So medieval India was the period of Delhi Sultanate. Qutbuddin Aibak, what he built Quwwatul Islam, Qutb Minar, and Adai Dinka Chopra in Ajmer. Then in Bengal, Adina Mosque at Pandua, Tomb of Jalaluddin Muhammad Shah, and Tandipura Mosque are the specimens of medieval architecture. Then in Jaunpur, Atala Mosque was built by the rulers of Delhi Sultanate. And what is the speciality of that Atala Mosque? There is an artistic grill around the dome. And the ceiling is decorated with Indian designs, including lotus. Then, which are the remarkable structures in Malwa? In Malwa, Mandu buildings, tombs with impressive domes and carvings with marble tomb of Ocean Shah are remarkable. Then in other regions, Bamini rulers, what did they build? A gold gumbaj at Bijapur. Then Madrasas at Bidar and Gulbarga. Then who built that temples of Vitala Swami and Hazara, that rulers of Vijayanagar. Then write about the progress of that architecture in Gujarat. Temples of various religions, mosque, then Vihara, stupas, cave temples and the Chaityas of the Buddhist and Jain temples indicate the remarkable progress of architecture in Gujarat. Besides royal palaces, forts, then domes, gates, kirti stumps, then upasrayas, wells, step wells, lakes and ponds, figures of animals and birds are the beautiful specimens. Then temples. Temples of different sects of Hindu religion have been built in large numbers in Gujarat. That most famous temples built during the period was Bhadragali temple, Gita Mandir, Veda temple, Jagannath temple in Ahmedabad, then Jyotrai temple at Indakur, Sun temple in Modera, Hatkeshwar temple in Vatnagar, Ambaji temple, Shyamalaji temple, Somnath temple, Jagat temples in Dwaraka, Bahujarji temple, Mahakali temple in Pavagadh, then Swami Narayan temple, Brahmaji temple in Ked Brahma, Kodiyar Madaji temple in Bhavnagar, Asapurama temple in Kutch, then mosque. mosque were built by the Muslim rulers. And which famous mosque is famous, that Jama Masjid. Who built that? It was built by Ahmad Shah, where it is situated in Ahmedabad, Teen Darwaja. Then Siddi Sayyid Grill, Mosque of Queen Cyprian, Ahmedabad, Rose of Sarkaj, and Jama Masjid of Chambanir. Then Jain temples were also built during that period. Which were the Jain temples built during that period? Jain temples of Hathi Singh in Ahmedabad, Kumbhariyaji, that Shangeshwar, then Siddhgiri, then Palitana, Shetranjai. They are the well-known for their sculpture, carving, and the architecture. Then step wells also were built during that period. They were step wells of Adalaj, Dada Harini Bab of Ahmedabad, Ranki Bavin Patan, Hira Bagor of Daboi. They are the splendid specimens of a step well construction. Then the other specimens of architecture are Fort of Badra, Teen Darwaja, Nagina Wadi, and the Kankariya Lake in Ahmedabad, Rudra Mahalaya in Siddhpur, Sasraling Lake in Patan, Shamalji Temple, then Samadhi of Tana Riri, Kirti Toran of Vatnagar, Mansar Lake in Viramgam, and the Malar Lake in Dholka. Then we have studied about a linear sketch of a mosque. What is Galiyara? The way to enter and exit from the mosque is called a Galiyara. What is Qibla? Part of the mosque or hall where that Muslim devotees offer their namaz, and it is always in the direction of a Kaaba. Then what is a Mahrab? The interior part of the mosque wall, which is of a human height and which is in the direction of Mecca, is known as a Mahrab. In India, it is always in the direction of a west. Then Sahan, campus where that Muslim followers, Islam followers get together for prayer is known as a Sahan. Then what is Liban? The room in a mosque with the pillars. And the last one is a Maksura. That end of the mosque wall is known as a Maksura, which is separated by a railing. This lesson is completed and I gave some of the questions as an assignment. They are all important and the answers also in this, from this lesson onwards, I have given the question and answers point wise I have given. You have to write down the question and answers also point wise given. You have to write in your history notebook. So first question is explain the town planning of ancient India. Second one, give detailed information about the roadways and drainage system of a town planning of a Mohenjo-daro. Third one, give information about the case of a Gujarat. Fourth one, give information about a Dholavira. Fifth one, Lothal was an important port of Gujarat. Explain. Sixth one, write about the art of pillar inscription. Seventh one, write a note on Sun Temple of Modera. Eighth one, what is sculpture? Ninth one, what is architecture? 10th one, explain the meaning of Mohenjo-daro. 11th one, explain the meaning of a stupa. Write down the answers in your notebook, history notebook.